Well, who's ready for Turco-Kurdish War II, Northeast Syrian Boogaloo? I hope you are, because it's here. The Turks have started their much mused about over the past few years invasion of Northeast Syria, which is the Kurdish held territories there. As I've talked about, the U.S. decided to pull out because the Turks made it pretty clear, hey, we're moving in. Don't get in our way. And the U.S. said, oh, we don't really care that much. We're not going to fight you. And you're in NATO. And Trump just like, yeah, this is a big mess. I don't want to be involved. So Trump took his, 50 troops out or something, who were just there as advisors. They weren't actually, they were more like human shields, actually, because nobody's going to invade the Kurdish areas while they were under sort of, while they were a U.S. protectorate. Because that's what, the Kurdish controlled state there was, even though they didn't consider themselves to be a state later on because they wanted to reconcile with Assad a bit. But anyway, that region was considered to be a U.S. protectorate and the U.S.'s sphere of influence. So Turkey wasn't going to invade there. It's like in the same way that Turkey wouldn't invade Ukraine and take back the Crimea, even though that's ancient and southern Ukraine, that's ancient Ottoman territory. And so in theory, Erdogan would want that just as much as he wants northeast Syria. But anyway, here we are. The bombs are beginning to fall. The F-16s are flying overhead. The Kurds apparently have been building tunnels and bomb shelters for quite some time in anticipation of this. It's no shock. The Turks have been talking about this for years. They wanted to do it. And since I talked about the U.S. side of this issue the other day when Trump decided to pull out and why I think from an American perspective there's really no reason to be involved, I think today I should focus on what's actually going on there. Now, as I suggested the other day, the U.S. should have facilitated a reconciliation between Assad and the Kurds a long time ago so that something like this wouldn't have happened. And now, quite belatedly, the Kurds are trying to reconcile with Assad now that they've lost their American protectors. The reason why the Turks want to invade northeast Syria, I guess their biggest pretense, even if they have other ulterior motives, is that the YPG they see is essentially the same as the PKK, and the PKK is a Kurdish group in eastern Turkey that has been at war with the Turkish state for decades. And Turkey feels like if there's a Kurdish-controlled government that shares a border with Turkey, that they will use that as a staging ground to launch terrorist attacks on Turkey. And so, this was never a problem when Assad controlled this part of Syria because, then you had Arab troops on the border. They drew a line between the Syrian Kurds and the Turkish Kurds. So it kind of, prevented them from launching, joint attacks against the Turkish state in the view of the Turks. So were Assad to come back in to northeast Syria and reestablish his border with Turkey and make it clear that, he's the authority there and that the Kurds are not, I think that the Turks would lose their pretense for invading this territory, although they still would want it. And the reason for that is because the Turks have taken in all of these – well, one, I should say, Erdogan has for a long time seen himself as sort of the Putin of Turkey, in that he wants to rebuild the former glory and restore the glory of Turkey as it was before it was broken up. So he wants to amass new territories. He sees himself as a sultan kind of guy, even though he doesn't call himself that. People call him mockingly the sultan because he wants to make Turkey great again. And so if, Turkey could expand its borders, which is what, the Assad government is accusing it of in this case, and the Turks are not saying they're expanding their borders. But if they could do that, that would be a good thing for the glory of Turkey, just like, the annexation of Crimea was a good thing for the glory of Russia as far as Putin and his supporters are concerned. Now, there's also another reason why this is a good thing for the Turks to annex or at least, take over, conquer this area. And that's because they've got all these Arab Syrian refugees in their country that they've been threatening for years to unleash on Europe but never end up actually letting them out. So they've just got all these Arabs in camps in Turkey. And, Turkey is an ethno-state. They don't want all these Arabs. They've already got enough problems with the Kurdish minority. They don't need an Arab minority. And so what the Turks can do by capturing this this bit of territory is they can, Erdogan's been saying, establish a safe zone where they can resettle all the Syrian Arabs back in Syria. That's the idea. But this is actually in and of itself a 1-2 punch, because on the one hand, Erdogan's able to unload all of these Syrian refugees that he doesn't want and get all the Arabs out of his country. And two, he's able to overwhelm the Kurdish population in this part of Syria, because, of course, this is a Kurdish, largely Kurdish area of Syria. And if he's able to settle all these Arabs here, they will overpopulate the Kurds and will sideline them and marginalize them. So then this will become an Arab-dominant area, and the Arabs are much friendlier to Turkey than the Kurds are. So this is not outright ethnic cleansing in that he's not removing the Kurds, although he'll probably kill a lot of them in this invasion. But what he is doing is he is engaged in what they call population engineering. In that he's trying to sort of plant the seeds. He's farming, essentially, the population here. He's engaging in sort of manipulated demographics. He wants to plant the seeds of Arab civilization in the Kurdish areas, and hoping that, as an invasive species, they'll be able to conquer the natives. And just to be sure, I'm using that in a... I'm not saying that Arabs are... in general are an invasive species in this part. Obviously there are plenty of Arabs in there, but they're not the dominant majority like they are in much of the rest of Syria. You know, these Arabs that Erdogan wants to unload in northeast Syria are for the most part not from northeast Syria, they're from the rest of Syria. And they went north up through Turkey and ended up, in camps there. So, Erdogan is resettling Arabs from the west of Syria in the east of Syria. Now, apparently, the Syrian Arab Army, the Army of Assad, is invading this same territory held by the Kurds from the south. I don't know if they plan on directly combating the Turks. That would be quite an interesting battle to see Assad fighting Erdogan. But apparently, the president of Turkey, Erdogan, has been in talks with Putin of Russia, and they were discussing this whole operation before things got underway. So it seems that there's some kind of mutual understanding here. Because, of course, Russia is backing Assad, and I'm sure there are going to be Russian troops embedded with Assad's forces. There's some kind of mutual understanding here that they're both, if not cooperating, but at least coordinating their actions in some way. And that makes me think that this is some kind of a Molotov-Ribbentrop situation, which, it's hard for me to believe that the Syrians would and the Russians would accept that. I should explain, Molotov-Ribbentrop refers to when Hitler and Stalin partitioned Poland, and they agreed that, okay, I'll take this half and you take the other half. That's what it's kind of seems like they're doing, because what happened in that case is that the Soviets and the Nazis both invaded Poland around the same time and from opposite directions and just conquered half of the country each. And it looks like, since Erdogan's invading from the north and Assad is invading from the south, that they're trying to perhaps each take a chunk of this territory. But oddly enough, as a counter to that, the Kurds are saying that they are engaged, and that the Russians are also saying that they're facilitating this. The Kurds and the Assad government are trying to come back together and rebuild their relations. And so if that's the case, then you wouldn't think that Assad is going to war against the Kurds. You would think that he'd be going to war on the Kurds' behalf against the Turks. Because if the Kurds are negotiating to come back into the fold, that would mean that, the Kurds would be giving up this whole territory essentially to Assad. So this is a very fluid situation. I would keep watching it, and I will obviously have an update tomorrow. Hopefully we will know, if we know more, and we'll actually know what exactly the details of this operation are, whether or not the Turks and the Syrians are, fighting each other, or if they're cooperating, or what the Kurds are doing, how they're holding out. We should all know more about that tomorrow. So if you gained anything of value out of this video, I'd appreciate you clicking that like button and sharing this video. And if you haven't already, please do subscribe, because I do upload every day, and I'd hate to have you miss one. So I'll see you folks back here tomorrow.